In today's vector analysis class, we are going to discuss linearization of functions of more than two variables. The linearization of f of x by z at a point p naught, x naught, y naught, z naught is L of x by z is equal to f of p naught plus fx of p naught into x minus x naught plus fy of p naught into y minus y naught plus fz of p naught into z minus z naught. L of x by z is the linear approximation of f of x by z at x naught, y naught, z naught. Suppose R is a closed rectangular solid centered at p naught and lying in an open region on which the second partial derivatives of f are continuous. Suppose also that absolute value of fxx, absolute value of fyy, absolute value of fzz, absolute value of fxy, absolute value of fxz and absolute value of fyz are less than or equal to m throughout the closed rectangular solid R. Then the error is defined as E of x by z is equal to f of x by z minus L of x by z in the approximation of f by L. The error is bounded throughout by R by the inequality. Absolute value of E is less than or equal to half into m into absolute value of x minus x naught plus absolute value of y minus y naught plus absolute value of z minus z naught the whole square. So we do a problem. So this is a question. Find the linearization L of x by z of f of x by z is equal to x square minus xy plus 3 sin z at the point x naught, y naught, z naught equal to 2, 1, 0. Find an upper bound for the error in replacing f by L on the rectangle R, modulus of x minus 2 less than or equal to 0.01, modulus of y minus 1 less than or equal to 0.02 and modulus of z less than or equal to 0.01. So this is actually a rectangular solid. It's not a rectangle. So we have, first we have to find the linearization. So solution. We have the linearization L of x by z is f of p naught plus fx of p naught into x minus x naught plus fy of p naught into y minus y naught plus fz of p naught into z minus z naught. So here p naught is x naught, y naught, z naught, that is equal to 210, and f of x by z is x square minus xy plus 3 sin z. Therefore f of p naught is 2 square minus 2 into 1 plus 3 sin 0. So that is equal to 4 minus 2, that is equal to 2. And we have fx is 2x minus y. Therefore, fx of p naught is 2 into 2 minus y is 1. So this is 4 minus 1, that is equal to 3. And fy is minus x. Therefore, fy of p naught is minus 2. We have fz is 3 cos z. Therefore, fz of p naught is 3 into cos 0, that is equal to 3. Therefore, a linearization of f of x by z is L of x by z equal to f of p naught. So this is f of p naught plus fx p naught into x minus x naught plus fy p naught into y minus y naught plus fz p naught into z minus z naught. So you know that f of p naught is 2 plus fx p naught into x minus x naught. Fx p naught is 3. 3 into x minus x naught is 2 plus fy into minus 2 into y minus y naught. Y naught is 1 plus fz into z minus z naught. Z naught is 0. So this is equal to 2 plus 3 into x minus 6 plus minus 2y plus 2 plus 3z. So this is 3x minus 2y plus 3z minus 2. So this is L of x, y, z. That is L of x, y, z equal to 3x minus 2y plus 3z minus 2. So this is the linearization of f of x, y, z. Now we have to find the upper bound for the error. In replacing f by l on the rectangular solid, modulus of x minus 2 less than or equal to 0.01, modulus of y minus 1 less than or equal to 0.02, and modulus of z less than or equal to 0.01. So we have the error is bounded by half into m into modulus of x minus x naught plus modulus of y minus y naught plus modulus of z minus z naught the whole square, where this m is taken to be the maximum of modulus of fxx, modulus of fyy, modulus of fzz, etc. So we have f of xyz is x square minus xy plus 3 sin z. Therefore, fx is 2x minus y. So this implies fxx is 2 and fxy is minus 1. And you know fy is minus x. So this implies fyy is 0. And from this also you know that fxy is minus 1. And fz is 3 cos z. So this implies fzz equal to minus 3 sin z. And fxz equal to 0, fyz is also equal to 0. Therefore, maximum of absolute value of fxx, absolute value of fxy, absolute value of fxz, absolute value of fyy, absolute value of fyz, absolute value of fzz. This is equal to maximum of absolute value of fxx is 2, absolute value of fxy is 1, fxz is 0, fyy is 0, absolute value of fxx, fxz is 0, absolute value of fyy is 0, absolute value of fyz is 0, absolute value of fzz is modulus of 3 sin z. We have maximum of modulus of 3 sin z is 3. This is because 3 sin z is maximum and sin z is 1. A maximum value of sin z is 1. Therefore, maximum of these quantities is 3. Therefore, we may take m to be less than or equal to 3. Therefore, the modulus of E is less than or equal to 1 by 2 into 3 into modulus of x minus x naught is 2 plus modulus of y minus 1, y naught is 1, and modulus of z minus 0, the whole square. And in the rectangular solid, this is less than or equal to half into 3 into modulus of x minus 2 is less than or equal to 0.01 plus modulus of y minus 1 is less than or equal to 0.02 plus modulus of z minus 0 is less than or equal to 0.01. So this is less than or equal to 3 by 2 into 0.04 square. So this is equal to 0.0024. Therefore, the error will not be greater than 0.0024 in the linear approximation. So that's all for today.